Hey all, here OS Reviews. You're watching our hands-on review of the Spare One Emergency Phone. As the name implies, this is not meant to be a replacement for our powerful smartphones that have the latest games and apps and media content on it, but rather it's meant for a backup emergency purposes, perhaps putting it in the car, putting it in a cabinet somewhere in an emergency kit, and it's powered by simply a standard AA battery, which can last up to 15 years before it needs to be swapped out. So really, it's meant for those cases where, say, the electricity is out. If the touchscreen breaks or cracks and you can't access it anymore, then something like this could be a great way to still have access to emergency contacts, 911, and get you help when needed. The premise is as simple as it gets, and this phone actually came out a few years back, and it retailed for $60, which I thought was kind of expensive and was one of the reasons why it wasn't too successful. But because of that, you can now find this on Amazon for a very low cost, as it should be, as an emergency gadget that should be accessible to the masses. In fact, you can find this one now for only $5.99 with free shipping and brand new condition. Now, this unlocked version only works with 2G bands, so it's going to work well with T-Mobile in the States. Again, there's another AT&T variant that works well with AT&T as well. Simply pop in any SIM card, either prepaid or with a contract, and you'll be able to make phone calls very quickly. And basically only phone calls because, again, there is no display for sending text messages. Other unique features include a geolocation function, such as if you are pressing the panic or emergency key, it will send your location to your favorited contacts as well as to the authorities like the police, so they're able to know where you are. And that's simply using triangulation to estimate your location and then see that on a map. You can also save up to 9 contacts, M1 through M9. Just tapping on a key will dial their number automatically without having to type the phone number in, just to save you on time. Otherwise, it also has a built-in LED torch to act as a flashlight in those emergencies. Now, it comes in this very interesting looking packaging because it claims to be actually waterproof, a $20 value, kind of funny because now this entire thing isn't even $20. And that claimed 15-year battery life is in standby mode. If you're making phone calls, obviously that's going to be shorter, and that is with the included Energizer L91 battery, which is a high endurance pack. Now, you don't even need to put in a SIM card if all you want to do is call 911, so that's the emergency call button, and again, it's easily replaceable, up to 10 hours of talk time with the single AA battery. There's also a panic SOS alarm that you can activate, and it will create the siren. So to open up the waterproof pouch, you simply open up this Velcro strap, and inside here we have the kind of Ziploc compartment, which has been tightly sealed. The phone itself is made entirely out of a polycarbonate plastic, and in terms of the overall height, as you can see here against a device that has a 5.7-inch display, it is very much comparable, but a lot lighter because it doesn't have as many internals, very much easy to hold using just one hand. We just have the earpiece, we have this very interesting cutout that is molded to conform to the shape of the battery, and down below here we also have the numeric keys themselves. They're pretty tactile and responsive and easy to press, raised above the surface of the unit. The bottom features a microphone and also a lock key if you want to deactivate the keys for whatever reason, but still have it turn on, maybe using it as a flashlight. And on the rear here, we have the compartment for the battery along with a lanyard strap. So if I remove the battery compartment, that's where you can swap out this Energizer cell, but more importantly, this is also where you put in the SIM card. Now, what's very interesting here is that they've also included a SIM card ejector tool in here as a backup. So again, if you are normally using your regular cell phone, but again, your phone is out of power, this is also where you're able to kind of remove the SIM card and then pop one in. So it's very thoughtful in terms of the design, and they even give you a tray that can adapt the size of the SIM card from a micro one to a full size. Now, this particular version of the phone does not have kind of a backlit keyboard. So in darker environments, it could be a little harder to access. But the AT&T version of the Spare One has glow-in-the-dark keys, which I think is a feature that this one should have had. This is the unlocked variant that is meant for the global market. And again, the AT&T one is specific for the US region. But both are selling for about the same price of $6 with free shipping on Amazon. So you can pick the version that you want in the links down below. Otherwise, if we turn it on again, let's try some of the other features. such as the flashlight here. You can simply tap on this once and it turns on, and once you release the key, it instantly turns off, as you can see there. The flashlight itself is simply LED, so it's quite energy efficient and very bright, and definitely will help in the case of an emergency. Now, I can also long hold on it to have it always turn on, as you can see there, and simply long hold on it again to quickly turn this function off. Otherwise, I can also tap on the numbers here to make a call, and it's simply going to read back what I press.
2, 5, 8, 6, 3, 1.
Now, pressing on the hang-up key will refresh and basically delete everything that you've entered into the D-pad so that you can start fresh. Otherwise, the volume key works by tapping on it to change the volume from high to being very soft. Now, the phone call quality itself, when I tried it with a prepaid T-Mobile SIM card earlier, sounded fine. No real issues as far as reception is concerned. I could still make phone calls and receive phone calls without any problems. A few final reminders to quickly keep in mind. If you are relying on this for the kind of geo services, like in the email as far as, and the location, that is going to be reliant on this company Spare One being alive and their website being up and running. With these phones not selling particularly well and now being sold at really low costs, it is a little bit doubtful whether their website will always be up and running, so perhaps activation of that function might be disabled in the future if their website goes down. But of course, you still have access to your emergency contacts and numbers. You can still use it as a regular kind of backup phone, but again, that location service function might not be something that's accessible. So that's Spare Phone, an emergency phone that's as simple as it gets. You have access to a flashlight, some very basic functions. So if interested, you can find out more details in the links down below, but for now, that's been our video. Thanks for watching here at OS Reviews. That's been a closer look at the Spare One Plus emergency phone here in 2019.